Hi there. Welcome back to VFX Rendering. With the Cinema 4D 2025 update, Maxon has unlocked a powerful new feature for all users, the Spline Deformers that were previously limited to Maxon 1 subscribers. This is a big deal if you're into motion graphics or procedural modeling. Just a quick note, these new spline modifiers don't show up under the Create tab like regular objects. Instead, you'll find them tucked away in the Deformers section on the right-hand panel, so make sure to look there. In today's tutorial, we're going to explore the electric spline modifier. I'll use it to create an abstract electric spark effect, perfect for motion design, sci-fi visuals, or anything that needs a bit of dynamic energy. Let's jump right in and see what we can create. Let's start by creating an impossible torus. Normally, this kind of shape can be made by twisting and bending a simple cylinder object. But in this video, I'll build it using an object group inside node space for more control and flexibility. First, add an end side node to create the shape profile. Set the key parameters like radius and number of sides according to the look you want. Next, add a second end side node to define the path the profile will sweep along. Then, connect both end side nodes using a sweep line node. This will extrude the profile along the path, giving us the base geometry. Now go to the rotation section of the sweep node. Adjust the graph that controls rotation along the X and Y axes. Make sure to activate the rotation front and ports to enable full control. You can tweak these values to define how the torus twists along the path. Keep in mind that a full rotation is 360 degrees, which equals 2 pi, also known as tau. This helps create the illusion of a continuous loop, even though geometrically, it's not actually possible. Finally, group all the nodes into a single scaffold, and give it a clear name like Impossible Torus for easy reference. And there you go, I've just built my own custom Impossible Torus using Scene Node. Next, let's create a cover layer for the torus. Start by adding a noise selection node. Enable the necessary parameter ports, especially those that allow you to control the noise over time. Use the frame number as an input to animate the noise, and make sure to divide it properly to smooth out the movement. Then, chain together a delete node. A thicken node. And a polygon bevel node. Adjust each node's parameters to fine-tune the thickness and bevel style of the cover layer. These steps will give your cover a nice layered, dimensional look. To view both the original torus and the cover layer at the same time, use the children operation node to combine and display them as a single geometry. Next, I'll assign color to the cover using the color operation node with a basic gradient node. This helps visually separate the cover from the torus and makes the final effect more readable and appealing. Once you're happy with the look, it's time to keyframe the values, especially the index values or noise parameters, to match your animation goals or overall design intent. Finally, group everything into a new scaffold named Cover Layout to keep your nodes set up organized and clean. At this point, I've created an impossible torus with a dynamic, animated cover layer. To create the connecting splines, we'll start by adding a spline node. Next, add two link objects in the input tag, one for the control point and the other for torus and its cover. Use a simple null object for the control point. This null will act as the origin of our spline connections. Next, using the closest points node, create the control parameters and connect the necessary ports together. The result will be an array of indexes of points on the torus surface and the cover closest to the control point according to the control distance. To access the actual positions of those closest points, use a geometry property getNode to extract the position data from both the torus and its cover. Then, use a getElementNode to retrieve the specific points that matched in the closest point search. Using a buildArrayNode with elements from the control point and the nearest points we just got. Finally, using the assemble spline node, we will have spline lines connecting between control points and the torus. Now it's time for the fun part. Apply the electric spline modifier deformer to these splines to generate animated electric spark effects. Feel free to explore and experiment with the parameters. Adjust things like frequency, amplitude, noise, and tension, until you get the exact look you want. And that's it. I've just created a dynamic electric spark effect using the electric spline modifier in Cinema 4D. This approach gives you a lot of creative flexibility, whether you're working on motion graphics, abstract visuals, or just experimenting with procedural setups inside Node Space. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on future content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.